Welcome, brothers and sisters, to the Catholic Mass at St. Henry Catholic Church in Gresham, Oregon. My name is Father Charles Zock, and I'm joined by our musicians, Michelle and Barb, our reader, Marcy, and our videographer, and our greeters, Jim and Peggy. Today is the 28th Sunday of Ordinary Time, and we're honored today to have a baptism of little Ethan, a reminder that we are also called to the banquet of the Lamb. Let us now stand as we begin with our opening song. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Gospel calls to mind that every day of our life we're invited to the wedding feast honoring the very Son of God. So we pause a moment, preparing our minds to celebrate word and sacrament, calling to mind our sins and asking for the Lord's pardon. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people.
Give you thanks for your great glory.
grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the word of God.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a feast of rich food and choice wines, juicy, rich food and pure, choice wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from every face. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we looked to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad he has saved us. For the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, I know how to live in humble circumstances. I also know how to live with abundance. In every circumstance and in all things, I have learned the secret of being well fed and of going hungry, of living in abundance and of being in need. I can do all things in Him who strengthens me. Still, it was kind of you to share in my distress. My God will fully supply whatever you need in accordance with His glorious riches in Christ Jesus. To our God and Father, glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Jesus again, in reply, spoke to the chief priests and elders of the people in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son. He dispatched his servants to summon the invited guests to the feast, but they refused to come. A second time, he sent other servants, saying, 'Tell those invited, behold, I have prepared my banquet. My calves and fattened cattle are killed, and everything is ready. Come to the feast.' Some ignored the invitation and went away, one to his farm, another to his business. The rest laid hold of his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged and sent his troops, destroyed those murderers and burned their city. Then he said to his servants, 'The feast is ready, but those who were invited were not worthy to come. Go out therefore into the main roads and invite to the feast whomever you find.' The servants went out into the streets and gathered all they found, bad and good alike, and the hall was filled with guests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
be to you. Please be seated. The parable of the wedding feast for the son. We should accept this parable in the light of 2,000 years later. The invitation is still coming every day of our lives, again and again and again. And what is this wedding feast for the Son? It's the bridegroom, Jesus Christ, preparing to marry the bride, the church, the people of God. That's ongoing. that wedding feast, honoring the Son. But we have an option. We can choose to accept or not. To accept means to accept the gift of salvation. To decline is to decline that which is revealed in Christ Jesus and our own salvation. We're required when we come to the wedding feast to wear a garment. The garment is the tools and grace to accept the very gospel, and the tools and the grace to preach that gospel, because we are all partners as we come to this wedding feast. We don't come alone. Many who were unworthy did not accept. Fortunately, the king sent out to all of those on the byroads, the good and the bad, that's where we all come in. And they accepted and came to the feast. Every time we accept the invitation, every day, we add another thread to the garment that we are to wear. Accepting the gospel, portraying the gospel in all that we say and do. I wish to share three stories about the ultimate salvation in Jesus Christ. All three of these stories take place in heaven. One is about the Methodist minister John Wesley. The other is about the founder of Salvation Army, General William Booth. And the other is about you and me with St. Peter meeting at the pearly gates. Once John Wesley told his people that when he got to heaven, he would be surprised at what he saw. He would be surprised, first of all, who was there? People he didn't expect. And he was surprised who was not there. Those whom he thought would be shoo-ins to get into heaven. The third surprise was that he found himself there. And then he said, he found himself there because the Lord's ways are surprising, full of mercy and love for sinners. It's a wonderful image that John Wesley shares. And then comes General William Booth, the founder of the Salvation Army, who welcomed and reached out to the poor and needy in society's image. They would say about him, he was reaching out to the unsalvageable. So a poet wrote this poem entitled, General William Booth Enters into Heaven. The poem describes who welcomes him when he got there. The unwashed lepers, the vermin-ridden saints, the bull-necked convicts, the loons and the trumpets. All had been warmly welcomed by him, and now he is welcomed into heaven by God. All were present at the wedding banquet of the Lamb. And the third story is about you and I as we come to the pearly gates after we die. As you know, St. Peter vets anyone. He has the keys to the kingdom. You can't get in until you answer at least two questions, well worth asking ourselves every day of our life as we decide to accept or reject the invitation to honor the Son. First question. St. Peter will ask you, were you loved and loving in your lifetime? We hope that when we gather for the funeral that all of those there will nod yes with us. Yes, he or she was loved and loving. The second question from St. Peter has to go like this. So who are you bringing with you? No one comes to heaven alone, so we are all expected to unravel a long scroll. Who is on that list? Those that we are responsible for in our life, those for whom we are accountable. And even after we die and are accepted into the heavenly kingdom, we continue to be responsible for them with Jesus Christ before the throne of God. Today is Ethan's first opportunity to accept the invitation to the wedding banquet of the Lamb. It's also his birthday, so he will be able to remember this day for the rest of his life, being received into humanity and being received into the very house of God. For today, Rico and Ellen, you're giving little Ethan another parent, God the Father, and he can inherit what God the Father promises him. You're giving him a brother, too. I know he's already got a sister, but now he'll have a brother by the name of Jesus Christ to take him by the hand through all of life's invitations. And then he will be baptized in the Holy Spirit. He will be a temple of the Holy Spirit, reflecting the face of God for the rest of his life for what he says and does. That's a reminder for us too. Our invitation comes again and again. We can respond yes or no again and again. We can accept our garment, the tools, and the grace as the vesture to wear as we are partners of the gospel in our lives. Let us now all stand as we pray together with the family and with Ethan, renewing our own baptismal vows. Parents, godparents, and our assembly here at St. Henry, through the sacrament of baptism, the child you have presented is about to receive the love of God in new life by water and the Holy Spirit. For your part, you must strive to bring him up in the faith so that his divine life may be preserved from the contagion of sin and may grow in him day by day. If your faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, then mindful of your own baptism, renounce sin and profess the faith in Jesus Christ, the faith of the church in which this child is baptized. And so I ask parents, godparents, and family, and this assembly, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
And do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church, which we are proud to profess in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And if the bridal party, pardon me, the wedding party will remain seated, come forward with little Ethan, and the rest of you may be seated. I ask parents and godparents once again, is it your will that little Ethan should receive baptism in the faith of the church which we have all professed with you? It is.
It is.
Ethan, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Almighty God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ has freed you from sin even and given you new water, new birth by the Holy Spirit, and joined you to his temple. He now anoints you with the chrism of salvation, that you may remain as a member of Christ, priest, prophet, and king unto eternal life. Ethan, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. May you see in this white garment a sign to you of your Christian dignity. With your family and friends to help you by word and example, bring that dignity unstained into everlasting life. Amen. You can hold that right in front of his eyes. Parents and godparents, receive the light of Christ. This light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly, so that your child, enlightened by Christ, may always walk as a child of the light, and persevering in the faith, may run to meet the Lord when he comes, with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. Amen. And you can stand right here. Ethan, may the Lord Jesus Christ, who made the deaf hear and the dumb speak, open your ears that you may hear the word of God, and bless your lips that you may give glory and praise to God the Father. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And now let's welcome little Ethan into the Father. To the Lord, offering our needs and our lives.
For the church, the living body of Christ, called to be the loving and healing presence of Jesus in the human community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations work together to end human rights abuses, especially exploitation of women and children, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the men and women who sit on death row, awaiting the end of their life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the families who have lost loved ones, lost their homes, lost their jobs, in these trying times of COVID, fires, and hurricanes, may the generosity and prayers of strangers ease their pain. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we who gather here unified in our faith, hungry for Jesus, foster a heartfelt reconciliation with God and one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Ethan, baptized here today, may he grow up surrounded by the love and support of this community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have requested our prayers and the prayers we carry in our hearts.
We continue to pray for all of those who have lost their homes in Oregon through the wildfires. And in Thanksgiving, we remember those who have reached out to them. We have one family in our own parish who wishes to remain anonymous, who took a 30-foot trailer fully stocked with everything needed and dropped it off near Sublimity yesterday and hooked up the trailer for someone who had lost all of their belongings.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God who created heaven and earth, protect what you have planted. Guide your people. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. This will become for us the bread of life. Through this mystery of water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. This will become our spiritual drink. Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me of my sin. Sisters and brothers, we pray together that this, our sacrifice, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, creator of the world and source of all life. For you never forsake the works of your wisdom, but by your providence are even now at work in our midst. With mighty hand and an outstretched arm, you led your people Israel through the desert. Now, as your church makes her pilgrim journey in the world, you always accompany her by the power of the Holy Spirit and lead her along the paths of time to the eternal joy of your kingdom. And so with the angels and saints, we too sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest.
Through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that, converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may he keep us in communion with Francis our Pope and Alexander and Peter our bishops, with all bishops and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saints Henry and Cunegunda and all the saints, with our brothers and sisters and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship, bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Command formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you all.
And
let us now share a sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, as you make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. And now we're going to have the mother hold Ethan and give her a blessing, and then the father will hold Ethan and will give the father a blessing. The Lord God Almighty, through his Son, born of the Virgin Mary, brings joy to Christian mothers as they see the hope of eternal life shine forth on her child. May he graciously bless the mother of this child, so that as she now gives thanks for the gift of her child, she may always remain united with him in thanksgiving. In Christ Jesus our Lord, amen. Amen. Now if you could pass the baton, little Ethan, to Rico, the papa. May the Lord God Almighty, the giver of life both in heaven and on earth, bless the father of this child, so that together with his wife, they may by word and example prove to be the first witnesses of the faith to their child. In Christ Jesus our Lord, amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, for we have been given a new birth also into eternal life. And may the Lord Jesus bestow his peace on all who are here. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Amen.
We believe.